Welcome back to another Minecraft Skyblock video. Today, the goal is to really just upgrade my current sword that we have, and of course, also doing a ton of other things on the island. So the first thing I want to go over and actually do is make a beacon. The reason I want to do that is because I was going to do it last video, but completely forgot. So basically, I've been doing a ton of off-camera grinding with just no beacon at all. I've been killing a ton of zombies and blazes, got up to island level 36, and of course, kept all the stats points in / IS stats. I've kept all the points. We still have 35. But basically, I was killing them at a slower rate, these blazes, as well as zombies. And it's not really effective when you're killing them at a slower rate. It's just so silly to do that. But I wanted to make the beacon on camera. So what we need to do is go into shop, and we're gonna look for, I think, miscellaneous. And we're gonna buy a beacon, which apparently is 10 million now. And that's pretty much all our money, but it's definitely worth it. And it gets us a quest for 2 keys, which reminds me, we're gonna be going on a opening spree with all the loot I've collected over the past few days, or 2 days to be exact, so a couple of days. Basically all the key all loot and all of the skill loot I've been saving, so we can open it on video. So for the beacon, we need to go into shop and we need to buy iron blocks. It is quite pricey, and I think we need 3 stacks total, which is quite literally $2 million. This beacon is way more expensive than it was last season. It was so easy to make a beacon last season, so at least they're upping the price on this. I can't really complain. From my knowledge, this might be the right height, or I'm mistaken. I think it needs to be 4. So let's go ahead, pick up this beacon really quick, and we're gonna make this one more taller. I've honestly forgotten how to make a beacon. Oh my gosh. So I pretty much almost made the beacon. We just need to buy a bit more of iron blocks. As you can see, it's not fully made. Okay, so the alt is quite literally in the way of this. I'm gonna probably just set up my alt right here. IS delete, and we're gonna do warp AFK, and then we're gonna create warp, and we're gonna set AFK back over to this spot now. I got rid of the alt and I put the block down, so basically now it's just gonna move over to right there. There we go, it's moved over, and also I did get some more zombie spawners, so we do have a ton more of them. Not really a ton, I should say. We've got around 9 spawners placed on the island out of our 25. Okay, so I placed the beacon down, and we got the strength 2 going. I activated it with strength. The rest of the iron blocks we're probably just going to get rid of now. Go ahead and do a quick sell all and make our money back. Some sort of money, I guess. So now if I kill blazes, you can see they're going down way faster than when I showed previously. It's just so much more convenient with the strength 2. And of course, the server version is 1.8.9 on its like base coding. So haste is not going to have any effect on attack speed because that was introduced in 1.9. The reason I'm mentioning that is because most of the people don't know that 1.8.9 does not have the haste effect that actually does the speed, like that you do kill the mobs at. It doesn't make a difference on attack speed, basically. But as you can see, we're getting a ton of XP, and we just leveled our island up to 37, and we're also getting a ton of blaze rods to make our money back, so this beacon was definitely worth it. And I'm probably gonna start using the keybind method, because you are allowed to use it where you like switch your attack key to something different. So if you swap these 2 keys around, you could just hold spacebar and kill the mobs. The only thing that they don't want you to do is AFK with this, so you have to be at your computer. You can't just go away for like 2 seconds and grab a drink or something. You should always be watching your screen, because staff, if they are checking you, will probably ban you. Basically, you just have to make sure to respond if a staff member looks at you or teleports you or messages you. That's basically it. So now I can just go ahead and hold spacebar and not have to click. It's so convenient. And we still only have 1 blaze spawner, which is kind of annoying. To be fair though, my alt account is staying on 24/7, so when I wake up every day, there's at least 1,000 blazes, which is not too bad. We just have to get it super consistent at some point. 1.4 million from 717 blaze rods. Oh my gosh, that is disgusting. So I set my controls back, and we're gonna start opening a ton of stuff. We got a robot egg, which gives a random tier of a random robot. We're gonna just go ahead and test this out. Okay, so which tier are we getting? We're getting a fishing robot, and it's a common. Unfortunate is what it is. And we got a common grinding one that I got from my skill, which is not too bad. I'll take it. And then we have a key all crate, which is pretty good as well. We're gonna be opening that soon. We did get an iron golem spawner from AFKing and grinding skill, as well as enderman spawners, and we got some epic airdrops we can open too. I also do have some grinding books we will be opening, because that's the main premise of the video. We're trying to get our sword up. That's the plan. And we got some pet eggs, of course, and keys. So we'll start with the key all crate. Let's just go ahead, open this up. Probably get nothing too great, but you know, it is what it is. An iron golem. Okay, that's not not too bad. So we'll go ahead and put the spawners away. So I'm checking really quick in shop. Apparently blaze rods sell for more than ender pearls, but right now we don't really have blaze spawners, so we kind of need to put down these endermen for the time being. So we'll go ahead, put them right here, and we'll stack them all up. These are basically going to be our blaze alternative to make money as well as XP and just kill better mobs compared to zombies. Let's move on to the epic airdrops. First one, here we go. Ton of money and a cell wand. Nothing great. Let's do the next one. More money and gems. We're getting pretty much nothing good. And we got a chat color bundle. Unfortunate. Oh, we got a zombie. Okay, that's more zombies, I guess. We'll go ahead and trash this bundle because we don't really need it. So I combined the cell wands. Basically, it says drop and drag onto another cell wand to merge. So I combined our current cell wand that we have just so we have that situated. And then we have a ton of keys we need to go ahead and open. So I'm going to organize them. So let's get the legendary out of my inventory first. So legendary, and then we have rare. And then, of course, we have common. So we'll go ahead, put the common, and then we'll do the vote keys first. So let's go ahead, go to warp crates, and let's get these keys going. We'll just go ahead and do a quick open on them. There we go. Get some spawners. Enderman, which is good. Okay. And what did we get? I think we got 4 pet eggs. Okay. Let's open the next one. Another pet egg. A blaze spawner. We needed that. Any chunk hopper is going to be useful for the time being, so I can't really complain about that either. So we'll keep that. But the pet eggs are actually pretty overpowered, I can't lie. All right, let's do the next vote. Another chunk hopper. Not another blaze, unfortunate. We did get a lot of zombies and some endermen, so I might honestly replace the zombies with the endermen now. We do have a ton of island value, and if we look in shop, I think we can sell that. Yeah, we can make a decent bit of money off of selling our value if we don't want it. So at some point, I might have to sell that, which I might honestly do pretty soon. All right, we'll put the next chunk hopper away, and let's go ahead, open up our next tier, which of course is going to be common. Let's go ahead, open a stack. We got a chicken spawner, nothing great. Unfortunate. Open some more keys. We'll just spam some of these open, see what we get. We got a sharpness. I needed that. An efficiency book, because I think sharpness 5 is max, so we'll go ahead and apply that in a bit. We got a cow spawner and more chickens. Okay, our last little bit of keys. Oh, we got a lot of books. Okay, we got speed, and we got lure for fishing. Okay, I'll make a PV for books. Might as well. Now we need to move on to rare. So let's open up the rare keys. 32. Let's see what we get. A zombie. Unfortunate. A stack. Here we go. Rare chunk hopper. We need one of those. And then 2 more keys for rare. Nothing too great. But we got a rare chunk hopper, so I can't really complain about that. Definitely pretty decent if I do say so. Okay, and then the final keys we have are legendary. So we'll get rid of these. As you can see, legendary can give some decent loot. So we'll just pop this open. Iron golems and blazes. Okay. We need the blazes, so I can't complain on that. And the stack. What do we get? A villager. Ooh, that's not bad, because we could use that to make an automated farm. I will not complain about that at all. And we got our first legendary chunk hopper. This was not a bad crate opening, I shall say. And from all those keys, we made 37 million, and we have 200,000 gems. Oh my gosh, the amount of loot we just got was insane. So we're gonna go back to the island really quick, and we're gonna put down the blazes. So we have in total 5 blaze spawners. And then we're gonna get rid of the enderman for a second, and get rid of the zombies. So the endermen, we're gonna go ahead and stack up all 12 of them. And then zombies, we're gonna go ahead and put in our PV1. So if I'm gonna be honest, we have 37 million. I'm thinking we should just get some more blazes, like buy 3 of them. So we'll go ahead and buy 3 blaze spawners for 30 million, 10 mil per. We just need more blazes. They're essential off the start if you're trying to do grinding skill. I'll put my robots in PV1 for the time being, because I don't really know what to do with these for now, at least. And then PV, I think 3, we'll put pets in here that we don't need, of course. Let's go ahead, open up some pet eggs. Give us something good. We have 17 of these. A logging pet, common. A grinding pet. Oh my gosh! I just pulled one of the best pets. Nah, that is actually absurd. That is the best grinding pet you can possibly pull in the game. And I was hoping we would pull one, and we did. Oh my gosh! That is actually insane. That fits the video very well, too. So now we can just start using this one. Oh my gosh, and we get a default 25.2% grinding skill boost. That's just disgusting. I want to just spam open these now. Let's see what we get. Can we get any masterfuls? Got some legendaries. I'll put all the good ones, the highest of each tier, into my PV for the time being. And I think there's 5 different types of pets for each skill. So if I get a higher tier, I'll upgrade it or just put it in that slot. Let's see what we get. Did we get anything good here? Okay, it doesn't look like it. And then we got 5 more after this, so we'll go ahead and put these away. I don't really know what to do with the spare pets, which is kind of annoying. But there we go. We got a grinding pet masterful. Oh my gosh, that is crazy. So I just found found something else that is actually really cool. The way you open the pet, or like the animation it comes in, is absolutely insane. Oh my gosh. And then when it leaves, it does the same thing. That is so cool. It goes through a portal. That is actually insane. But there we go. Now we get even more skill XP to get our skill up, because I believe we're around 30 on our skill right now. And every time this levels up, we're getting 0.2 added on to the current boost that we have on this pet, which is even more disgusting because I don't know how high of a level this thing can even go to. And we got our books we still need to open, by the way, and we got another book. Okay. I think it's safe to say we should go ahead and upgrade our sword now, though. So let's go ahead and get rid of our pet for the time being, and we're gonna go ahead and go to Warp Enchanter. So I haven't been here yet this map, and it looks pretty cool, the Warp Enchanter. Not bad. So we got Brandon the Bookworm and Tim the Enchanter. What's the Bookworm? And select one of the three. Oh, okay. So we're gonna get Arthur's sword. I think we want that. What else do we want here? We want looting. We want multi-kill. We want dual XP. Perfect. I'm gonna say this right now. You can see what Meets PayPal does. It gives you coupon currency. Personally, I don't need that as a partner on the server. I am partner rank, so I don't need this. So the alternative I'm gonna get is Book Hunter, even though I probably should get the Meets PayPal. It is what it is. But we're gonna keep going and seeing what we get. So right now, we're currently like on no archaeologist, so I would like to get one of those, and then we'll get another book hunter. And what else can we get? Look at Arthur's sword again. Okay, so we need to organize which ones we want to put on first. So Tim the Enchanter, you go here and you basically just put a book in, and it'll give you a percent on it, and you apply XP and hope it applies to your sword or whatever you're applying it to. So we're gonna figure out which one I want to go into first. What I was thinking was maybe dual XP, so we're gonna try. Please work. Yes, I think it worked. Dual XP is an insane enchant, so I'm glad that did actually go through. And we also got a ton of quests while we were opening all these books, which is really nice. Multi-kill apparently only goes up to one, so I have a spare for no reason. What about looting? Let's get looting up. All right, we got looting. We'll get a Book Hunter, 99.9%. That's actually convenient. So we got Book Hunter 2. We'll get our Archaeologist up as well. We'll do some Arthur's Sword onto there, and another one. There we go. So most of our books applied, actually. I think all of them did. Oh my gosh. So if we go in PP5, I think we have some more books we can apply. Yeah, it was sharpness. I want to apply up to sharpness 5. So if we go to enchants, you can see which types for each enchant tool. So we'll go to sword. Sharpness goes up to 5. I want to get it up to 5 just so we do the most damage on at least sharpness. I don't really care for any of the other enchants like smite. So we'll apply this, and there we go. So we just need one more sharpness book. Okay, so I'm looking on AH and there's sharpness books. We're going to buy this one and see if this applies, please. There we go. It was a million, and the rest were super pricey. So our current sword is looking absolutely amazing. I want to test this out. So we go back to the island, and we're going to quickly sell all our loot. And we have looting 1, which will make us even more money. So we turn on our pet, and we'll go ahead and change over to our hotkey or keybinds. We'll swap them around, press spacebar, or hold it. Oh, we're killing the zombies. Oops. Okay, there we go. So now we're killing blazes, and we should be getting way more XP whenever dual XP procs, which is nice. I'm not 100% certain on how much looting has been changed by us actually getting looting 1. I'm just not too sure. I'm pretty sure we killed around 100 blazes and we got double the blaze rods. I may be mistaken there, but it looked like we did. And we still have a ton of XP, and we don't have enough books to apply, so we're pretty much out of books. Okay, we'll go ahead and get our skill up, so we're just gonna grind that up really quick. And I do want to go ahead and invest into some stat points on our island into like certain upgrades. We'll take a look at the upgrades that I want to invest in though, so we'll check those in a second. There we go, we got a XP boost if we claim that. That's a really good one. So we'll go ahead, go here, and I think it's 32 now. No, it's 30. Okay, we hit 30. Of course, there's 100 levels on each skill, so I can't wait to get up to these. So in that little amount of time, we made over 500,000. That is crazy. So with all the island value I get, I am actually gonna consider just putting it into the value station. The reason I say that is because there's a seasonal amount, and I want to see how much we get in this whole season. So I think if you just right click it, yeah, there we go. It puts all the value in your hand into it. And of course, there's a weekly for the weekly payouts. The payouts are also not for PayPal, they're for gift cards on the server. So if you really enjoy the server, it's worth going for it, I guess. But as you can see, that is our seasonal amount so far, and every week this resets. I don't know when it resets, but it is what it is. Also, I got battle pass rewards. We're gonna claim all this. And we got a logging book. Okay, I don't really need that, but I'll take it. And we got a pet egg. We'll open the pet egg. bag, a logging pet, which is legendary. Okay, so we got an upgraded one. Perfect. Okay, so since we have the logging book, we're actually gonna open it and hope we get something for our grinding sword. Let's see. None of it was good. Oh my gosh. We'll get efficiency though. So we'll put that in PB, I think 5 it was. Yeah, we'll put the efficiency in there. So we need to go to IS stats. I completely forgot about that. We need to go into IS stats and let's take a look at what we can get. So I'm looking over the stats and I just don't know what to get. The only thing I think I should get is the spawner limit. So we're only gonna get one upgrade to see how high it puts us. So let's take a look, and we now have 50 spawners with the current 20 placed on our island. So I guess we're gonna have zombies down as well since we have more spawner space. That was definitely worth it. I just don't think any of the other stats are useful for me specifically for the time being. But there we go. We got our sword up to a decent amount. Did a lot of island progression. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one.